start with the name of Allah, who's most beneficent and graceful. Biology first year, chapter 13. Today's topic on gaseous exchange in animals. My name is Sanjay Kumar, lecturer in zoology, government boys degree college, Sakhar. Table of contents, definition of gaseous exchange, factors affecting gaseous exchange, respiratory media, gaseous exchange in animals like Hydra, earthworm and cockroach. Gaseous exchange. First of all, definition of gaseous exchange. Gaseous exchange is the exchange of gases between an organism and its environment is called gaseous exchange, and it is a biological process through which different gases are transferred in opposite direction across a specialized respiratory surface. Like us, are we inhale air and take oxygen in our body and exhale carbon dioxide from our body. So these gases are move in opposite direction, come in oxygen and take out carbon dioxide. From air is our environment from where we take oxygen. As we can take an example of gaseous exchange, why it is necessary. For example, a person can live without food for a month. A person can live a week without water, but a person cannot live without air or oxygen for 5 minutes. If we stop oxygen for a person for 5 minutes, he becomes died off. So it means the supply of continuous supply of oxygen is necessary. This oxygen comes in our body and used for the production of energy. This oxygen diffuses inside the cells, and where oxygen comes in contact with mitochondria and produce ATP. जैसे हमने या आपने पढ़ा होगा पहले ये bioenergetic topic में कि किस तरह oxygen produce करती है energy in case of Krebs cycle or electron transport chain. So, gases exchange एक process है जिसके अंदर gases opposite direction में जाती है, जिस तरह इसे दिखाया गया है कि यहाँ से यहाँ जा रही है और यहाँ से यहाँ जा रही है in opposite direction. Gases exchange are of two type. First is the gases exchange at external and gases exchange internal. Gases exchange external means exchange of gases in our environment, in our body, is known as gases exchange. Taking air, oxygen into the body and take out carbon dioxide from the body. But internal respiration or tissue respiration, also called cellular respiration, which is from between the blood and the cells. Blood se oxygen diffuse out ho raha hai into the cells, or cells se blood or carbon dioxide diffuse out ho raha hai blood ke andar. Ab inme gases jo hai wo opposite direction mein move kar rahe hain, oxygen in aur carbon dioxide out ho raha hai. Ye kyun ho raha hai? Through the process of diffusion. Diffusion kya hai? Movement of molecule from area of high concentration to area of low concentration. Once inside the cell, the oxygen is used for producing energy in the form of ATP. This ATP is used in our body for our cellular functions, and our life becomes going on smoothly. Factors affecting gases exchange. Gases exchange in organism take place by process of diffusion. There are some factors which affecting gases exchange. First is the maintain diffusion gradient. So what is maintenance of diffusion gradient? This maintenance of diffusion gradient means the differences in the gases concentration. For example, the larger the differences in the molecule, higher the rate of diffusion. Jitna molecules zyada difference hogi concentration gradient mein, utni zyada diffusion hogi. Jaise example lete hain ke ek kamre ke andar a bottle of perfume is opened, then the molecule of the perfume is spread out from one corner to the another corner. This is why, because of molecule move from high concentration to area of low concentration. Similarly, in our body, when we take in air inside our body, oxygen rich air gives oxygen molecule to our body, lungs, and carbon dioxide which is produced in our body is take out from our nose during exhalation. Large surface area, second is a large surface area in relation to volume. It means the respiratory surface must be a large enough to catch the oxygen molecule. Larger the surface area, we catch easily. Presence of moist membrane. The gaseous exchange must be take place in a moist membrane. Without moist membrane, gaseous exchange not take place. In second, the large surface area to volume, the definition is written here. Volume is the amount of space inside an object, and surface area is the total area of surface. Respiratory medium. So what does mean by respiratory media? Media means source. Here respiratory medium means source of oxygen. जैसे हम न्यूज में सुनते हैं न्यूज मीडिया, मीडिया मीन्स सोर्स. यहाँ पर रेस्पिरेटरी मीडिया मीन्स सोर्स ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. जैसे कि लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म लिव इन टू एरिया, वन इन केस ऑफ लैंड विच इज कॉल्ड टेरेस्ट्रियल एंड अदर इज वाटर. सो इन लैंड एयर इज अ सोर्स ऑफ मीडिया एंड इन वाटर द वाटर इज ओनली सोर्स ऑफ मीडिया. Aquatic organism get oxygen dissolved in water which is only 5%, why terrestrial organism obtain oxygen from air which is 21%. Here the percentage of oxygen in air is higher, so rate of diffusion in terrestrial land is more as compared to in case of aquatic life. And water is also denser as compared to air, so it also make a difficult for aquatic life to get a water easily. Gases exchange in Hydra. Gases is exchange in Hydra. Hydra, it is a multicellular animal having body wall made up of just two layers, outer ectoderm and inner endoderm. Cells of both layers are in direct contact with water. So In water, the dissolved oxygen go inside the cells, and carbon dioxide diffuse outside the body. As the water moves inside and goes outside, it carry oxygen and give oxygen to the cells. Similarly, carbon dioxide moves from the cell and go along with the water to outside. Large concentration of oxygen in water diffuse into the cells, as I written description here, and we also see the structure of Hydra. This is the anatomical structure of Hydra, in which this cross section shows there are two layers of Hydra. Outer is epidermis, which is known as ectodermis, and inner is known as endoderm. Outer ectoderm is surrounded by different cells which I have already studied. You already studied in a chapter number 10, Kingdom Animalia, and in chapter number 12, Digestive System for Gastrovascular Cells or Gastroderm Cells. But here we see only there are two layers. One is the outer, another is the endoderm. In between two, there is a mesoglia, which is non-living layer cells present, but they are simple multicellular organisms. So oxygen diffuse easily. There is no specialized respiratory system is there present. Second is the respiratory organ of earthworm. Earthworm has no specialized respiratory organ, so it uses its wet skin as a respiratory surface. Why? Earthworm belong have organ level of system, so in order to cope or in order to overcome the situation of providing each cell oxygen and food, they have closed circulatory system. In order to keep the skin moist, earthworm has to live in a damp soil. The moisture is absorbed by the mucus secreted from the goblet cells in the skin of earthworm. The skin is richly supplied with blood vessels. The skin is richly supplied with blood vessels. In earthworm, blood contains respiratory pigment. Hemoglobin carries oxygen to the tissue. Here the respiratory pigment is different from us is that hemoglobin is in our body embedded or present inside the red blood cells, while the hemoglobin of earthworm is diffused in the plasma. The oxygen present in the air diffuses into the mucus layer and then it diffuses into the blood through the wall of capillaries. In the same way, carbon dioxide expels out through the skin. Here we see structure of earthworm. Earthworm is a segmented animal, and here shows the cross sections. This is the anatomical view of skin. This is the ectoderm, endoderm. There are little tiny pores present. Oxygen diffuse from outside to inside, and similarly carbon dioxide diffuse outside. This richly is oxygenated beneath the skin area contain large amount of oxygen. This oxygen is carried by the blood vessels and blood from that area to the which area where oxygen is needed. Here the transportation of carbon dioxide and oxygen inside the blood vessels of earthworm. Respiratory organ of cockroach. Cockroach has evolved a special type of invaginated respiratory system called tracheal system. It is a specialized adapted for intake of oxygen, terrestrial mode of life, high metabolic rate and compact the body of an insect. Tracheal system consists of internal tubule called trachea, which is connected between spiracles and tracheal fluid. The trachea opens outside the body through a minute slit pore called spiracles. These are spiracles, and there are 10 pair of spiracles. Means 10 spiracles here, right side, and 10 spiracles on the left side. So 10 pair of spiracles. Two are present in the thoracic cavity and the 8 in the abdominal cavity. So this is the structure of insect. This is called head, and this is called thorax, and this area is known as abdomen. So this is thorax. In thorax there are 2 spiracles on the right side, 2 spiracles on left side, and 8 spiracles in abdomen on the right and left side. So there are 10 pair of spiracles. Spiracles are little pore where the oxygen goes from the air into the slit pore and carbon dioxide moves out. From here the oxygen is traveled into inside, and this inside carrying a trach like structure. This is called trachea. From the trachea the air goes into the branches. These branches are known as tracheoles, and these branches are directly connected with the cells. So these cells are direct in contact with the oxygen. These oxygen goes directly to the cells, and from the cell carbon dioxide go outside these like spiracles. The cockroach takes in air directly from the atmosphere into the trachea through spiracle, as we stated earlier. This air diffused directly into the fluid tracheole, through which diffuse into the cells of tissue, and the blood vascular system of cockroach is devoid of hemoglobin. So inke liye zarurat nahi hai hemoglobin ke liye. Kyun? Kyunki respiratory pigment ka kaam hai oxygen ko cellon tak pahunchana, lekin yahan par oxygen direct contact hai tracheoles, directly contact hai cells se, so directly oxygen tak mil rahi hai, to inko zarurat nahi hai kisi bhi respiratory pigment jaisa ki hemoglobin. Removal of carbon dioxide from cells of body is largely depend upon plasma of blood, which take up carbon dioxide for its ultimate removal through body surface via cuticles and also by the spiracles. There is little animation cockroach ho ya fir इंसेक्टों के अंदर यही ट्रिकी सिस्टम है जिसके अंदर हम देख रहे हैं कि ये हेड है और ये थोरेक्स है, ये एब्डोमिन है, और इनके अंदर लिटिल लिटिल सेगमेंट्स हैं, और जो कि आपको एनिमेशन में दिख रहे हैं ये जो छोटे छोटे पोर्स हैं इसको हम बोलते हैं क्या, स्पाइरिकल्स। इनके जरिए ऑक्सीजन इन होती है और कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड आउट होती है, और इसके बाद ये देखें आप, और इसके बाद ऑक्सीजन डायरेक्टली सेल को मिलते हैं। फिर लिटिल एक्सरसाइज फॉर यू, रेस्पिरेटरी मीडिया फॉर टेरेस्ट्रियल ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर, टेरेस्ट्रियल ऑर्गेनिज्म में ऑक्सीजन कहाँ से मिलती है हम सबको पता है, डेफिनेटली इन केस ऑफ टेरेस्ट्रियल लाइफ इज एयर। अर्थवर्म, मॉइस्चर इज एब्जॉर्ब्ड बाय म्यूकस सीक्रेटेड फ्रॉम स्किन इज म्यूकस ग्लैंड, गॉट ग्लैंड, स्वीट ग्लैंड, गोब्लेट्स ग्लैंड। सो ये हमारे गोब्लेट सेल्स होते हैं जिनके से म्यूकस सीक्रेट होती है। वॉल्यूम ऑफ वाटर व्हेन सैचुरेटेड विद ऑक्सीजन कंटेन अबाउट 10% ऑफ, जब ऑक्सीजन पूरी मिक्स हो जाए वाटर के अंदर तो वो कितनी परसेंट कहलाती है, याद होगा आपको ये 5%। गुड। इन कॉकरोच एयर एंटर द बॉडी थ्रो, कॉकरोच के अंदर किस तरह ऑक्सीजन आ रही थी, वेरी गुड, स्पाइरिकल्स के अंदर। थैंक यू वेरी मच, कोई भी सवाल हो तो आप हमें कमेंट्स कर सकते हैं, मैं आपके लिए शुक्रिया कहूँगा, आपने हमें टाइम दिया, थैंक यू।